Hello children, in this video we are going to derive formula for force between two parallel conductors carrying current. Okay, before that you should be familiar with this formula. We will recollect this formula using Biot-Savart's law. We have calculated current carrying conductor at a point P, which is at a distance A, produces magnetic field B is equal to mu naught I by 2 pi A. And also we have learned that current carrying conductor in perpendicular magnetic field experience magnetic Lorentz force, F vector is equal to IL vector cross B vector, right? Now, for deriving force between two parallel current carrying conductor, you refer this diagram, children. You can see two conductors A and B with the current I1 and I2, right? Both are separated by a distance R. This conductor I1 is producing magnetic field B1 at a distance R from this wire. Okay, so I1 current carrying conductor produces magnetic field B1. So what is the direction of B1 here? If you apply right hand thumb rule, if you have to hold the conductor with your right hand so that the thumb point in the direction of current. I1 is upward, your thumb is upward, right? Now the fingers you curl around the wire. How do you curl your finger? Anti-clockwise, right? So the magnetic field direction will be anti-clockwise. Okay, children. So we will again discuss this later. Now you can see in this magnetic field B1 is the second B conductor with current I2. So this current carrying conductor in B1 magnetic field, it will experience force. B conductor will experience force towards the conductor A. Okay. Now we will step by step, we will calculate B1. Then we will find out DF. Okay. First we will see what is B1. Okay. Now, for that only I told you to consider right hand rule, okay, right hand thumb rule. So you have, this is the current conductor A with current I1. If you hold the conductor, thumb points in the direction of current, the fingers, curled finger in anti-clockwise, magnetic field is anti-clockwise, right? At this point, magnetic field is entering perpendicularly into the paper, goes down. At this point, magnetic field is coming out of the paper. Again, it is going into the paper. So, magnetic field at this point into the paper, magnetic field out of the paper here at this point. Okay. Biot-Savart's law, if you apply, before that, you can have to consider the axis, children. X, Y, Z are the three mutually perpendicular axes. Okay. X, Y, Z are the three mutually perpendicular axes. And I have also considered negative axis. My x and minus x axis, y axis, negative y axis, z and minus z axis. Okay, now you know that the magnetic field is going into the paper, right? Into the paper, that is into the paper which represents negative x axis. So you can introduce negative I cap. Okay, x, instead of x, you are introducing the unit vector I cap. Okay, along x axis, so I cap. Negative I cap. Okay, now we will calculate in the so B1 formula, you got mu naught I1 by 2 pi r minus I cap, right? So in this magnetic field, I2 conductor is present. So in this conductor, B conductor, children, you consider small elementary length DL. Okay, so when I2 comes to this DL, that current element I2 DL in B1 magnetic field will experience Lorentz force DF. Okay, so DF is equal to IL cross B. Here, instead of IL, you are writing I2 DL cross B1, I2 DL vector cross B1 vector. Okay, now this DL vector can be written as DL K cap, because I2 is along, look here children, I2 is along Z axis, no? So you are introducing, I2 is along Z axis, so introduce the vector K cap, unit vector, okay? So DL vector is DL K cap cross B1, already we know, we are writing mu naught I1 by 2 pi r minus I cap. Bring this minus sign here. So DF vector is equal to minus mu naught by 2 pi I1 I2 DL okay, by R. Here K, you take all the terms commonly out, okay, constant and all, you have to take it out. K cap cross I cap in the bracket, okay. Again, I will repeat, children, minus mu naught by 2 pi r I1 I2 dl, in bracket you can write K cap cross I cap. What is K cap cross I cap, children? You know that K cross I is nothing but J, right? K cross I is nothing but J. This you have learnt in max, right? So instead of this, you can write J cap. Okay. So this is the Lorentz force expression for the elementary length. And you know that the Lorentz force DF, it is acting toward the conductor A. In this diagram you have referred. Okay. Lorentz force is acting toward the conductor A. Okay, children. So this is the Lorentz force for unit length. You want to calculate force. Okay. Lorentz force for per length. So in that case, what will you write? F by L is equal to minus mu naught I1 I2 by 2 pi r J cap. Okay, you have to note down this formula, children. Now you refer this diagram, children. This is the, instead of this diagram, instead of this diagram, which you see, you see the same diagram, an overview. Okay, you are seeing from the top. So this I1 is the conductor, current carrying conductor coming out of the paper. I2 current carrying conductor coming out of the paper. Okay. So this I1 is producing magnetic field in anti-clockwise direction. At this point, magnetic field produced by this I1 conductor is tangential. Okay. Tangential. Okay. This is B1 direction. If you apply Fleming left-hand rule, you can say that this current carrying conductor, I2 current carrying conductor in this perpendicular magnetic field, okay, I2 is out, B1 is this way, so these two are perpendicular, it will experience Lorentz force FB towards conductor A conductor, okay. Already, and also you note down, children, you can say that in this answer you got minus J cap, right? So direction of minus J cap, it is Lorentz force is acting along negative y-axis. This is negative y-axis, right? You can see this is negative y-axis. Negative y-axis, right? So, F vector is acting along negative y-axis. You can also apply Fleming's left-hand rule, okay? Same way, children. Instead of previously you consider A conductor, right? Now you can consider B conductor with I2 current. It will also produce magnetic field in anti-clockwise direction, right? So at this point, magnetic field B2, okay, I2 conductor produces B2 magnetic field. It is coming out of the paper, right? So B2 by Savart's law, B2 is equal to mu naught I2 by 2 pi r. It is coming outwards, that is along positive x-axis. So introduce I cap vector. Okay. Now same way, in this B2 magnetic field produced by the I2 conductor. So in this magnetic field B2, I1 current carrying conductor is there, right, children? So this I1 current carrying conductor in B2 magnetic field will experience a force towards B, okay. So magnetic I1 current carrying conductor in B2 magnetic field experience magnetic Lorentz force DFA, okay, which is towards B. We will calculate DFA. Same way, in the conductor A you consider the elementary length DL, okay. So I1 DL is the current element. So magnetic Lorentz force is equal to I1 DL cross B2, okay, you have magnetic field B2. So we will write DL vector as DL K cap, because I current is along Z axis, so K cap cross B2 value already you know, take all the constant out, so you will inside bracket you will have K cap cross I cap. What is K cross I? This is nothing but J, right? So you replace this with J cap, okay. So what will you get? DFA, that is the force experienced by the A conductor, is equal to mu naught I1 I2 by 2 pi r DL J cap. And you know that the force DF of conductor A act towards B. Okay. Now force per unit length is F by L is equal to mu naught I1 I2 by 2 pi r j cap. Okay, children. And you have to note down on important point, children. If the current are flowing, you can see these two conductor current flowing in same direction, right? Now this current carrying conductor produces magnetic field anti-clockwise. You can apply right hand thumb rule. Okay, this conductor is also current is in upward direction, magnetic field is anti-clockwise. So what happened? Both the cases current is in magnetic field is anti-clockwise direction. See what happens here. Now there will be attractive force between these two conductor. Okay, if current is in same direction, then between these two wires there will be attractive force. In the other case, children, if the current is flowing in opposite direction, see downward and upward, if you apply thumb rule, what happened? The current is flowing in here in clockwise direction, in this wire the current is flowing in anti-clockwise direction. So magnetic field is in two direction. This is clockwise and this is anti-clockwise. What it means is, when the current is in opposite direction, there is repulsive force between the two wires, okay, two current carrying wires. Current same direction, attractive force between the wire. Current is in opposite direction, there will be repulsive force between the wires.